Okay, so first of all, as a developer, you must have the you must have strong command on logics. If you want to become a software developer, if you want to become a software developer, you must have the knowledge on two things. Okay, one is logics. In order to become a software developer, you must have the knowledge on two things. One is logics, other one is OOPs. If you are strong in these two things, you can become an expert developer. Any technology, whether Java or .NET or Python or PHP, whatever it may be, you can become expert if you are strong in those two things, logics and OOPs. So I want to launch this batch, especially many companies are focusing on logics. Logics, definitely you have to use your brain. You have to spend some time. Okay, now definitely you'll become expert, but don't option for the classes. Sit in the classes regularly. I'll make you expert in logics. In logics, mostly we'll try to cover operators and we'll try to cover some basic variables and here some data types. Okay, now and here some conditional statements. Conditional statements. Similarly, here some loops and here I'll try to cover arrays and I'll try to cover strings. These topics I'll try to cover. This is the common batch for everyone, any student, any BTech student or MCA student or any degree person, anyone who want to enter into the software industry, these logical programs are very, very helpful for you. So who can learn this logics? Anyone, BTech freshers. Is it there are M.Tech freshers or degree or MCA students coming to technology point of view, Java students, .NET students, Python students, Angular students, anyone, anyone can learn what? Logics. Companies will first priority, they will check your logical skills only. Okay, non-IT students, IT students, anyone. Is it clear, everyone? Anyone can learn this logics. Just join on to become a software engineer. First of all, you must know about what is software. You already know that story. What is software? Software is collection of programs. Software is collection of programs. Next, you can ask me why to develop a software. Why to develop a software? We have to develop software. We have to develop software to automate the manual process. If you want to automate the manual process, then we have to develop the software. Next, what is program? What is program? Simply you can tell, program is set of instructions given to a computer. Program is set of instructions given to a computer. Software is collection of programs. Program is set of instructions given to a computer. Is it clear? Program is set of instructions given to a computer. Sir, no. So why to develop a program? We have to develop a program to solve a particular task. Why to develop a program? Simply you can tell, we have to develop a program to automate a particular task. In order to automate a particular task or requirement, we have to develop the program. Manual process means through manpower. If you go to bank in olden days, you have to go to bank, stand in the line, take one token, and here one display board will be there. You have to go when your token will come, you have to go. The cashier will verify passbook and all these nonsense will be there. Now automate means now people are not going to the banks. Everything is through online. Sir, now people are using mobile apps. People are using ATM machines, Google Pay, Phone Pay, Paytm. Like all our transactions and everything will be done through online. Sir, no. So that is what? Software. You can take software means different types of softwares are there. Scientific softwares, application softwares like websites. Okay, na? Any applications are there. Embedded softwares, some mechanical related designing softwares, lot of softwares will be there. So what is software means? Software is collection of programs. Why to develop a software? We have to develop a software to automate the manual process. Program is set of instructions given to a computer. Why to develop a program? We have to develop a program to automate a particular task. So what skills are required? This is very, very important batch. Don't absent. Again, you will not get this batch. Okay, na? No online batch for logical programs, because I'm facing lot of problem, lot of requirement is there in companies, but students are very poor in logics. That is the only one reason why I announced this logical programs. Sir, now all of you try to join that link. What I have given for notes. Sir, now. So try to utilize this opportunity. Don't be irregular to the classes. Nobody can help you. If you're irregular, means nobody can save you. Okay, be regular, attend the classes regularly, become expert in logic programs. We'll do more than 100 plus programs in logics. Okay, so let us see what skills are required to develop the programs. Actually, if you want to develop any programs, you must have logical skills are very important. Is it clear? First of all, basic mathematics is enough. First of all, logical thinking is required. What is required? Logical thinking is required. Means problem solving skills are required. Logical skills are required. Some logical skills are required. Some mathematical skills are required. Basic mathematics is required. And some programming language, programming syntax is required. To become an expert in logical programs, you must have the knowledge on what skills are required. All these things are required. Logical skills, problem solving skills, basic mathematics, programming syntax. These all are required to become expert in programming. Basic mathematics means just addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, calculating the average marks, total marks, percentage of marks. These all comes under basics. Problem solving skills means understand the problem. How to understand the problem? By reading the problem several times. Is it clear? By reading the problem several times, you can understand the problem. Read the question. You people have a habit of without reading the question, you will write the answer. And you will get good percentage, 80 plus percentage, and you are waiting for your job. But companies are, today's trend is totally changed. Companies are not showing interest to give the jobs those who have only percentage. Logical skills are also important. Problem solving skills are also important. For that, no need of any degree. Just common sense is enough. Is it clear? Basic mathematics is enough. Programming syntax is required. Logical skills are required. Problem solving skills are required. Did you understand? So these are the basic points you have to understand. So initially, in order to develop, improve your logical skills, is it clear? These skills are very, very important. Everyone will have that skill. No need to do any PhD or degree to improve these skills. Below fifth standard is enough to become what? A programmer. That's what companies are also expecting. Those who try for government jobs, bank jobs, for them it is very, very, very easy to become a software engineer. They will feel that it is very difficult to become a software engineer because I am applying for a bank job and government job. It is very easy. Is it clear? Wherever you go, logic is very important. Sir, no, logic is very simple actually. Okay. So generally, we will learn this all concepts by following one approach actually, that is PDLC approach. Program development life cycle. I think you already heard about SDLC, software development life cycle. If you want to develop a software, you have to follow some approach. That is SDLC. Like by using waterfall model. Similarly, you have V model, waterfall model, V model, spiral model, RAD model, agile model. Nowadays very popular is Azrael model. If you want to construct a building, some architecture is required. You have to approach to a civil engineer, and civil engineer will give you what? Some design. By following the design, the contractor or builder will construct the building. And government also will give permission. If you have the design, you must get the approval from the civil engineer. Some Gram Panchayat or HMDA, layout means go to GHMC and apply for permission. First they will ask, go to a civil engineer and bring what? Design of your particular building. Then civil engineer will give you, will go to some designers will be there. We'll go and we'll have a design of that particular building. Is it clear? Then only the building construction will be started. Similarly, in software industry also, if you want to develop any software, every software company will follow some life cycle. That is SDLC, Software Development Life Cycle. Similarly, if you want to become an expert in programming, how to write the programs, how to become write the programs fastly and efficiently by following one approach, that is PDLC. PDLC means Program Development Life Cycle. SDLC means Software Development Life Cycle. It is an approach which is used to develop Program Development Life Cycle. Okay, this batch is not for Java or .NET, it is common for anyone. Java, .NET, Python, anyone can try to attend this batch. Very, very powerful batch. Are you following everyone? So, before starting PDLC, first of all, we must have the knowledge on some basics. What are the basics? We'll try to see here. First, we must know about data. What is data? Simply. What is data? Data is collection of raw facts. Data is collection of raw facts. Is it clear? Data is basically divided into two types here. Data is basically divided into three types. One is numeric data. Other one is character data. Numeric again divided into two types. One is integer. Other one is floating point. Character is also divided into what? Three types. One is single character, other one is group of characters, another one is alphanumeric character. Data is basically divided into two types. And here you have Boolean data is also there. It is into three types. Numeric data, character data, and Boolean data. So actually, if you want to become expert in what? If you want to become expert in what? Logics. If you want to become expert in what? Logics. Yes or no? If you want to become expert in logics, you must have the knowledge on data only. Our main job is to perform operations on what? Data. So whenever you want to perform operations on data, is it clear? Different type of data is there. Yes or no? Now you can ask me, what is a number? First of all, I'll ask you, what is some basic question? What is a number? Simply you can tell, number is a digit. Number is a digit or combination of digits. Number is a digit or my class is slow poison. Don't think sir is teaching very, very basic level. Okay, within 2 days you will go to very high end level. Loops, for loop, while loop, Fibonacci series, Armstrong number, reverse number, sum of even number, sum of odd numbers, palindrome, reverse the given string, find the number of vowels and the consonants in the given string, Fibonacci series. Lot of problems we'll try to discuss. Give me some time. Digit or combination of digits. Number is a digit or combination of digits. Different types of numbers. Different types of numbers are. Different types of numbers are. First one is single digit number. Single digit number. Yes or no? That is what? 5, 6, 0 to 9. 0 to 9 comes under single digit number. Next one, double digit number. Double digit number means what? 10 to 20. 10 to 99. That is double digit number. Yes or no? Next, coming to triple digit number. Triple digit number. Number is nothing but a combination of digits. Number is a digit or combination of digits. Triple digit number is how much? 100 to something like 999. That is triple digit number, like four digit number. These are very, very important to do the logical programs. Four digit number, something like you can go for 1000 to 9999. That is 4-digit number, 5-digit number, 6-digit number. Lot of numbers will be there. Are you following anyone? So number is a digit or combination of digits. For example, if I ask on small program, write a just display the sum of the digits. Display the sum of the digits for a given 4-digit number. For the given 4-digit number. Display the sum of the digits for the given 4-digit number. For example, if the number is something like this, if I try to give 4532. So what is the sum of the digits? How to find? So how many digits are there in that number? 4 digits are there. That is a 4-digit number. So generally, if I ask you to find the sum of the digits, this is 1 digit, second digit, here 2. Here you have what? 4532 generally. Now here 4 is in thousands place, 5 is in hundreds place, 3 is in tens place, 2 is in ones place or units place. So you can pronounce as what? 4,530. So in order to find the sum of the digits, what to do? 4 plus 5 plus 3 plus 2. This is very, very important question. 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 12 plus 2, 14 is the answer. So in interviews, they'll ask you. Logical programs, they'll ask you. Write a program to find the sum of what? 4-digit number. Is it clear? Generally, in order to do this program, you have to use some for loops. Which loop? For loop is required. How to do that one, we'll see later. This time, we are making some fun with these numbers. Yes or no? Now, here you can ask me. I will ask you one more question. Display the sum of the even digits. Display the sum of the even digits. Generally, basic mathematics is enough for the given 4-digit number. If the number is 4532, what to do? First step is check where the given digit is even digit or not. Check whether the given digit is even digit or not. Even digit or not. For that, you have to write some logic. What is that logic? We'll see later. So 4 is even digit. 2 is even digit. So 4 plus 2, answer is how much? 6. That is the answer. Is it clear? So how many digit? Which digit number is this one? 4-digit number. 4532. Here 4 is which digit? 4 is which one? Even digit. 5 is odd digit. 3 is odd digit. 2 is even digit. So 4 plus 2, how much? 6 is the answer. First of all, you must know how to read the question. How to read the question. Now, if I ask you, display the sum of the odd digits for the given 4-digit number. What are the odd numbers? Odd digits? 5 plus 3. How much? 8. Okay, now, first of all, you have to know that number is nothing but a combination of digits. Number is nothing but a combination of digits. Is it clear, everyone? Now, if I ask you, display the sum of first digit and last digit. Display the sum of first digit and last digit. Without the knowledge of logics, you cannot become a software engineer. If you want to become a software engineer, if you want to start your career as a software engineer, you must be strong in logics. First digit is 4, last digit is 2. Sum of the first digit and last digit is 6. Display the sum of middle digits. Display the sum of middle digits. Display the sum of middle digits for the given number. 5 plus 3, how much? 8. These all are just basic mathematics questions I am asking. But we have to convert all these mathematics into logical programs with the support of basic mathematics, programming syntaxes and everything. This all we will do in future. Don't worry. Okay, na? This all we'll try to do in what? Future. Yes, everyone. Here you can see. Similarly, but don't option the class. If you option the class, I can't do anything. That is your fate. The sum of the squares of the digits. sum of the squares of the digits for the given three digit number. Number is nothing but a combination of digits. I will give you one number, something like 123. Sum of the squares of the digits means what? 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. This is what we are asking. 1 square means how much? 1 square means 1 plus 2 square means 4 plus 3 square means 9. How much? 14. That is the answer. This is our mathematics, small mathematics. But for this, we have to convert into logics and develop the programs. Did you understand? If I ask one more question, write a program. Write a program to check whether the given number, three digit number is Armstrong number or not. Okay, now first of all, you must know what is Armstrong number. Simply I can tell. Armstrong number means sum of the cubes of the digits. Is equal to given number. If the sum of the cubes of the digits is equal to given number, then that number is called as Armstrong number. If the sum of the cubes of the digits, for example, you see 153. 153 means what? 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 3 cube. So, if the sum of the cubes of the digits is equal to given number. 1 cube is 1, 5 cube is 125, 5, 5 is 25, 25, 5 is 125, plus 3 cube is 27. Add all these things, what you will get? How much you will get? 153, yeah? Sir, no, 153. So, 153 is which number? So, 153 is Armstrong number. Sir, no. For example, another number I will give. 151 I will give you 10. 151 means what? 151 is Armstrong number or not? What to do? 1 cube plus 5 cube plus 1 cube. How much? 1 cube is how much? 1. Okay, now 1 plus 125 plus 1. How much? 127 is not Armstrong number. Are you following? Check whether given number is Armstrong number or not. First of all, you must have the knowledge on this concept. Yes or no? Now I'll give you some case studies. Some case studies on this one. We're gonna check whether the given numbers are Armstrong numbers or not. Armstrong numbers are not. I'll give some numbers. Some 534. Similarly, I'll give 1000. 1092. Are you following? Check whether the given numbers are Armstrong numbers or not. First, you must have the grip on all those things. Yes or no? You have to do manually. Yes or no? And here I'll try to give something like 0. 0 is Armstrong number or not? 1 is Armstrong number or not? Yes or no? 0 is Armstrong number or not? You have to decide. 1 is Armstrong number or not? 370 is Armstrong number or not? Like this you have to check. Don't take the support of internet. You have to do manually. Okay, now 371 is Armstrong number or not? All these things you have to check. Then you will get the command on what is Armstrong number. Are you following everyone? So, I told you what is Armstrong number and I am giving you some numbers to check whether the given number is Armstrong number or not. Then you will get the command on what? Then you will get the command on how to check whether the given number is Armstrong number or not. Then, what to do? Yes or no? then you have to think about logic. Like that, your logical skills will be improved. Yes or no? So first I started with number. What is digit? Number. Number is combination. Number is a digit or a combination of digits. Yes or no? Single digit number, two digit number, three digit number, four digit number. Your phone number is 5-digit number. Your bank account number is 12-digit number. Your Aadhaar card is 12-digit number. Your debit card number is 16-digit number. Yes or no? You must have the knowledge on number. Are you following? 4-digit number, say 1 cube plus 0 cube plus 9 cube plus 2 cube. Sum of the cubes of the digits is equal to given number. Then it is Armstrong number. Now here, check whether the given number is palindrome or not. If I ask you, check whether the given number is palindrome or not. What is palindrome? First of all, what is palindrome? Palindrome means if given number is equal to reverse number, then we can say that the given number is palindrome. We can say that given number is palindrome. What is palindrome? If the given number is equal to reverse number, then we can say that the given number is palindrome. For example, if I give 151, here I will try to write, this is given number and this is reverse number. Okay, now given number is 155, reverse it, you will get 151. So it is a palindrome. Okay, now if I try to give 1001, reverse it, you will get 1001. It is also a palindrome. If I give 573, reverse it, 375, not a palindrome. Yes or no? Similarly, you can take madam. Madam, reverse it, you will get madam. It is a palindrome. Malayalam, reverse it, you will get Malayalam. It is also a palindrome. Satya, reverse it, AYHTAS, that is not a palindrome. This is the palindrome string, last three. First three are palindrome numbers. Liril, L-I-R-I-L, yes, that is also a palindrome. Like that, identify some palindromes. This is palindrome. Given string is equal to reverse string, then that is called as palindrome. Dad, mom, very good. Amma, yes, I love that. Dad, that is also a palindrome. Mom, he told, again reverse it, mom, it is also a palindrome. He told amma, mother in Telugu, reverse it, palindrome. Like that, if I ask you one more question, something like this. Display the factorial of the given number. Display the factorial of the given number. If I ask you to display the factorial of the given number, what is factorial? Factorial of the given number. Factorial is the product of all the integers from 1 to the given number. Factorial is the product of all the integers. All the integers from 1 to given number, not 0, from 1 to given number. That is factorial. If I ask you 5 factorial means what? 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 5 4s are 20, 23s are 60, 62s are 120, 121s are 120. What is the factorial of the given number 5 factorial? 120. Similarly, if I ask you some 4 factorial, what you can tell? 4 into 3 into 3 into 2 into 1, you will get 12 to the 24. You can write 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, any manner you can write. Find the factorial of the given number. That is very, very important. Armstrong number, Factorial of the given number, palindrome. Display. Now check whether the given number is perfect number or not. Check whether the given number. Now we are playing with numbers actually. Similarly, we can play with strings also. Okay, na? Check whether the given number is perfect number or not. What is perfect number? Simply you can tell, a perfect number is a positive number. A perfect number is a positive integer actually. A positive integer that is equal to sum of its positive divisors. Sum of its positive divisors. Just addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These four things are enough to become a good programmer. Fibonacci series, I will tell you. Yes. Lot of integer that is equal to sum of its positive divisors. Some divisors means what? For example, if you check whether 6 is positive number or not. Means? Yes. Excluding the number itself. That is perfect number. Means 6 means what to do? 6 by 1. 6 divided by 2. And here 6 modulus 2. And 6 modulus 3. 6 modulus 4. 6 modulus 5. That's it. First of all, you must have the knowledge on one point here. What is the difference between by and modulus? What is the difference between by and modulus? Simply you can tell, by will gives us quotient. By will gives us quotient and modulus will gives us remainder. Modulus will gives us remainder. Are you following? For example, if I give something like this, if I give something like 5 by 2, what is the answer? Numerator is 5, denominator is 2. 2 how many times? 2's. How much? 4. Remainder is how much? 1. Okay, na? So what is the answer for 5 by 2? This is your quotient. This is called as quotient. And this is called as remainder. This is called as remainder. Are you following everyone? So 5 by 2 answer is what? 5 by 2 answer is 2. 5 modulus 2 answer is what? 1. 5 modulus 2 answer is 1. Okay, na? So what is the difference between by and modulus? By will gives us quotient and modulus will gives us remainder. Now check whether the given number is perfect number or not. A perfect number is sum of perfect number is positive integers that is equal to. A perfect number is a positive integer that is equal to sum of its positive divisors except the number itself. So here you say 6 modulus 1, how much? 6 1 is 6, remainder 0. 6 2, 6 modulus 2, 2 3 is 6, remainder 0. 6 modulus 3, 6 3 is 3 2 is 6, remainder 0. 6 modulus 4, 4, remainder is not how much? 4, 1, 4, 2. 6 modulus 5, how much? 5, 1, 5, 1. So what are the divisors of 6? Tell me. What are the divisors of 6? Now find the divisors of 6. What are the divisors of 6 here? 1, 2 and what? 3. Is it clear? Now find the sum of the divisors. Don't fear. Don't fear. If you fear, you are unfit for software job. 1 plus 2 plus 3. How much? 6. So 6 is perfect number. Yes, everyone. Did you understand? Find the divisors. 1, 2, 3 are the divisors of 6. Divisor means remainder is 0. Yes or no? Will you try some programs I will give? Case study? What is the case study I will give? Check whether 7 is perfect number or not. 7 means what? 7 modulus 1, 7 modulus 2, 7 modulus 3, 7 modulus 4, 7 modulus 5, 7 modulus 6. Not 7 modulus 7. excluding that number. Is it clear? Then similarly, check whether 4 is perfect number or not, or check whether 8 is perfect number or not. Like that you can check, so that you will get a grip on the mathematics, then you can easily write. We need to write no program, just checking. Do how I have done this one, in the same manner you have to do. Don't write any programs. We have not yet started any programs. Sir, no, you do with cool mind, pleasant mind, after the class, before sleeping, you once revise all these topics, you become expert. Okay, na? Like that you have perfect numbers or not, you have to check. Yes or no? Similarly, check whether 28 is perfect number or not. You check, you will get some clarity. You do, no problem. 24 times you do. Your brain will work at least. 24 is perfect, 28 is perfect number or not. Some formulas will be there to check. But are you following or are you fear? This is free batch, you are attend the classes regularly, everywhere you have doubts only. People are not satisfied with what they have. Always ask extra things. I didn't told 4 is perfect or not. 1 plus 2 plus 3, how much? 1 plus 2, I think. 4 is not divisible by 4. 28 is perfect number, yes. Bye. I will share the notes in the Telegram link. Tomorrow, try to improve your